Good evening, everyone. My name is Roger Fegan. I'm the Activities Director and Assistant Principal here at the high school. I just want to welcome everyone to Solstice, a combined band and choir holiday concert. All three groups are very excited to share their music with you this evening. Beyond being involved in groups like these, take hard work, dedication, and constant growth. The DHS administration is so glad that our students are involved in the performing arts and can truly see what the payoff to hard work is. In band and choir, your students get to actually feel, see, and hear themselves growing as they continue to rehearse their music. Tonight is the apex of their growth from this past semester. Thank you so much for coming, and please be sure to silence all devices at this time. Thank you.
Rogers if I do not know you. I'm the choir director here. And before Concert Choir gets off stage, I'd like to take a moment to say something to them and to all of you who are their parents, their friends, their teachers. Just as we asked you, what Grace spoke about before we started, to reflect on what you are thankful for this season, I've been reflecting on what I'm thankful for. Now I'd like to take a moment to share with you all about my gratitude for Concert Choir. Yes, I'm very proud of how much they have grown this semester, but more importantly, I'm very thankful for how amazing these humans are. They are kind, empathetic, welcoming, and they put a smile on my face every day during the sixth hour. This past Sunday, my husband's family, my family, had a pretty devastating loss. The funeral was actually today. I wasn't here at school. And that is why my husband, Mr. Dinkrado, is not accompanying today. So thank you so much, Terry, for stepping in last minute to play some tracks for us. We appreciate you. When I told the students I would not be here on Friday due to a loss in the family, this specific group of students showed me empathy and caring in ways that grown adults struggle to. I think it's a testament to how close they have grown to each other, but also how great of humans they are. So thank you, Prince and Quiet. I was going to announce our November Musician of Distinction. However, she is one of our several members who is unfortunately absent today. So that student will find out on Monday. And if Concert Choir could maybe not spoil it, you know who's absent and you can figure it out. But I will be saving that for when they are back. If Madrigals can come on up. Next up, we'll be hearing from Madrigals.
Thank you.
this person is hardworking, loving, humble, welcoming, and unbelievably talented. They're not only an incredible member of choir, but also a phenomenal band member. They are consistently the first person to learn their music, and in the year and a half that I have known them, their voice has blossomed. If you were at the fall concert, you were actually fortunate enough to hear them solo on Estelestido. Our musician of distinction for November is Olivia Jenkins. This ensemble is. This arrangement was sung last year as well, but the students begged for it to be a piece that we repeat, so it had become the annual piece. And it is definitely a collegiate level piece, and they stepped up to the occasion. To give you an idea, if you are a soprano one, will you raise your hand? If you are a soprano two, will you raise your hand? If you are an alto one, will you raise your hand? If you are an alto two, will you raise your hand? If you are a tenor one, will you raise your hand? If you are a tenor two, will you raise your hand? If you are a baritone, will you raise your hand? And if you are a bass, will you raise your hand? They're kind of in mixed formation right now. They're gonna go to a different setting. But I wanted to bring attention to that because this is not an easy feat, and they have done incredible. So I'm very proud of your work. If you can now get in your silent night spots.
Thank you. whoever you are. I am King Ari, and this Friday I welcome you to my very big castle.
Our very big castle, filled with lots and lots of money. More money than the humble town of Dixon and Sterling. I personally welcome you to our castle this Friday.
I'm Princess Nightingale, and I'd like to invite all of you to our humble magical dinner this Friday. And tickets will be sold after the concert, and I'm sure that Lady Rogers has more information on that after we are all done. Thank you so much. Good Yule and West Hail! West Hail!
Crossovers have a moment to change out of their costumes, and I asked those three you just heard to do that seventh hour today, so thank you to those. So yes, we're having a magical dinner this Friday, and we're very excited. It hasn't been done in Dixon for a very long time, and it's going to be just a very fun day. We've written the script, we've built the set, and there's laughs and a lot of beautiful music. In addition to the two pieces that you heard, they actually have about 12 more that they've been rehearsing. So you got to just hear a little snippet of what they've been working on. If you flip over your programs, that back sheet is the invitation. In the bottom portion you can fill out, or you can open your camera phone and open the camera and scan the QR code, and you can fill out the information. Because it is a dinner, we are asking that people order ahead of time so that we know how much food we need. So if you are planning on coming, the sooner you do that, the better that we can plan. So I appreciate those of you who have already submitted your information so that we can get working on that. We will be down here after the concert selling tickets if you'd like to get payment or purchasing it out of the way. And we will have hard copies of the forms if you don't want to tear out your program. And let me just check that I talked about everything I needed to. Yes, okay, so next up is the wonderful Marcia Comer.
Thank you all so much for coming tonight. I know it means a lot to me as a band prom, but it also means a lot to these bandos to have you in attendance. My name is Marcia Comer, and I am the president of the Band Boosters here at Dixon High School. My daughter Nani has played flute since fifth grade, and this year started playing piccolo also. My daughter being in the band is why I'm in the Band Boosters. But we have some upcoming events that involve the band and the choir. Obviously, they just talked about the choirs having a magical dinner next week. The Magicals have just done an amazing job. I am so incredibly proud of them every time I hear them. Also, Reagan Middle School is fundraising for some new music stands. The ones that they have are approximately 30 years old, and they are kind of really falling apart. They are doing a fundraiser where you can sponsor a music stand for $60. That includes a tag, a permanent tag on that stand. So you can do it in honor of someone, in memory of someone, maybe a special event or an occasion in your life. Maybe your business would like to sponsor one. If you're interested in doing that, we do have some forms. The forms are due by December 20th. So we would ask you to get a hold of Mr. Carter or one of the Band Boosters after the concert tonight. Also after the concert, the Band Boosters, we have a table set up over here by the wall. We are selling t-shirts, sweatshirts, such as this one. We're also selling cookie mix in a jar that is $10 a jar. We have four different varieties. So we feel feel free to stop by and see what we have to offer. Maybe you get yourself something good or get something for somebody else. We also have a pre-order going on right now for band uniform pillows, wilts, and wind chime caps. Only a certain amount of each of those are available due to the number of uniforms that we do have. They are made out of the old uniforms, and so they're being sold on a first-come, first-served basis. So please see Mr. Carter or Band Booster if you are interested in any of these items. And may I suggest that the wind chimes would make a great Christmas gift for your neighbors. Sometimes, when you have a dream, truly becomes a reality. And this happened for me in the past month. My dream was that my daughter, who is a junior this year, would wear a new uniform for marching band before her graduation from Dixon High School. That dream started becoming a reality April, May-ish, when Mr. Carter and some of the students and band boosters represented the band at a board meeting. The school board graciously voted and purchased 100 marching uniforms for our band. That dream became an even bigger reality when, in the middle of November, Mr. Carter sent a message to me that says, "Uniforms will be here tomorrow. Hope you don't work." That meant that it was going to be all hands on deck. We had to make room. I may have cried some tears of joy as a semi pulled up and pulled pallets of uniforms off of their semi. There were so many boxes, but everyone came together. We got everything unboxed, and that's when the real work began, as we had to meet the Dukes in 48 hours. And we had 34 bandos to get fitted. Needless to say, it all worked out. The bandos looked and sounded amazing for that event. And yes, I may have cried again when they marched out in their new uniforms with that huge plume on their head. No more dead chicken plumes for us. Now it's glorious 14-inch tall plumes that our tall bandos had to practice walking through doorways with because they don't fit. A very special thank you to Ms. Curley, Kayla from the Band Boosters, and Mr. Carter for all of your help getting those uniforms ready for that event. I appreciate all of you, and I appreciate all of your hard work for the band. At this time, I'd like to thank all the administration from Dixon High School and also the Dixon Public School Board for all of your help and your generous purchase for these new uniforms. The bandos are very excited and very thankful to represent our school and the music program while they wear their gorgeous new uniforms. A special thank you to all of my band boosters for all of your help, whether it be some crazy seam ripping night or cookie jar night or even t-shirt making night. Your hard work and dedication to the band does not go unnoticed by me, and I appreciate you. So with all of that, I'd like to invite you to consider joining Band Boosters. We meet on the first Tuesday evening of every month at 5:30 in the band room. The meetings usually only last around an hour, so it's not an all-night event. And we invite Reagan parents and Dixon High School parents to join us. Again, thank you so very much for being here tonight, and please enjoy the rest of the concert. And there will be a few minutes where the band is going to warm up, and then they will start their portion. Thanks.
Thank you. Which shows him what the wonder of life never fades for those who believe. As you listen, you'll hear themes featuring the memorable tunes, The Polar Express, When Christmas Comes to Town, Hot Chocolate, Believe, and The Spirit of the Season. We hope you all have your tickets as you prepare to ride The Polar Express.
Thank you. Sorry if you notice I tend to end up quite big, so if I look sound like I'm out of breath, I am. Thank you all so much for coming this evening. Give another hand to this group. They are knocking out of the park. These are so fun. So, for those of you who don't know me, my name is Riley Carter, and I'm the director of bands here at Dixon High School and the music department head of Dixon Public Schools. Again, I thank you for coming out to see these students play, and they've had some really awesome growth this semester, and I'm super proud to be their band director. And for the first concert of the year, I'm very impressed with the performance that they're putting on this evening. When we are getting together to the point where we can really start doing more than just playing the notes and rhythms on the page, and you can clearly hear by what they played just now, they're able to really understand what a phrase is. How do you speak musically? How do you communicate? We're talking about all of those things, and it's super exciting to hear them absorb it like a sponge. When we spend a lot of time fine-tuning our pieces, this concert cycle, and really try to accomplish some of that conversational plan that I mentioned earlier, one way we as performers do that is we have imagery about the pieces in mind that we play. Over the last few weeks, I've been talking to them about having an image in mind. It's pretty easy to pull out express because it's about a movie. But with other things, you have to really think about what is the musical story that is being told here. So in our last piece, I encourage you to use your imagination and really think about what story is being told. And maybe you can close your eyes, remember something back to a time when you were maybe a young kid on Christmas morning or whatever holiday you celebrate, and how exciting it was to see the snow falling for the first time and things like that. At this point, I want all of the choir students to make their way to the risers because we're going to do a joint piece with the entire music department here in a second. So if you'll give us just a few minutes to get those kids ready, then we're going to talk about some more really cool things our students have been doing over the last few weeks here. As they are getting set, I'm going to talk about BNC, which is the Big Northern Conference. Big Northern Conference Schools, which is the schools in our district, put on a festival each year to bring together student musicians. The students that form these honor groups are nominated by their respective directors from across the area. Rock Falls High School will host these students on January 16th with collegiate guest clinicians. We are so proud of all of these students and know they will represent DHS Music Department very well. Band students, when I call your name, please stand up and be recognized. Senior oboe player, Leah Keel. You can applaud. Senior trumpet player, Esther Whitman. Senior saxophone player, Tom Stouter. And junior saxophone player, Mike Cohen.
And choir folks, if you can raise your hand, we have Grace DeBoard, Katie Miller, are finding out right now, so Michaela Kirby, Dominic Zachary, and Green Bottwell. Leslie Petterini. Owen Winters. Are the students from Honors Choir. And from Concert Choir, we have Toby Lance, Cody Guile, and Leonard Dieter.
We want to congratulate our band and choir students who were accepted into ILMEA, Illinois Music Educators Association, District 8 Festival for the school year. The ILMEA Festival is where the strongest musicians amongst District 8 come together to make music. Preparation for this audition is very demanding and took each of these students hours upon hours to learn and practice both new music and technical skills. At the festival, they learned a great deal from the experts within the professional music field. They also got to meet other Day of Eight student musicians at their age from across the district. We are so incredibly proud of their hard work. One student from band who participated in this was James Coker, and I cannot be more proud of the work he's done, so thanks for that. something else, James Prokhorov of Rushman, he was sitting third chair, first part alto saxophone as well. Look at my hand.
For senior chorus, we had, I'm going to list all of them and then we will clap. Please keep your hand up. Sorry for the people listed first. We had Olivia Gingras, Leslie Paterini, Katie Miller, Ava Pizzera, Michaela Kirby, Anne McFarlane, Gianna Dukes, Molly Oliver, Grace DeBord, Owen Winters, and Dominic Zachary. And then for vocal jazz, same deal. We had Anne McFarlane, Allie Payne, Emmy Petterini, Olivia Gingras, Katie Miller, Grace DeBord, and James Popeye. Students who successfully auditioned to Island Yankee District Festival are also considered to represent their district at the state level. We have three wonderful students who will be heading to the Illinois Music Education Conference this January in Peoria, Illinois, with the other best student musicians from the state. We have two students make honors choir, which is incredible. We have junior Michaela Kirby. And sophomore Owen Winters. We also have a student.
We also have a student who has gone above and beyond for wanting to become a future music educator. There is one way you can get into this field, and it's with a lot of hard work. So Grace DeBord wrote an essay, if I'm wrong, Grace, I'm thinking about there, you wrote an essay and a bunch of different documents to kind of prove to the IMEA board that they are someone who is really invested in the choral world. She comes in and helps out Miss Rogers. I feel like I see you every single period. So you're in the music room pretty much all day, and she does whatever she needs to do. She organizes people. She's in both choirs. She is truly a force of nature and will be a phenomenal choir educator. So Grace DeBord is going to represent us at State for the Future Music Educator Seminar. Please give her a hand.
To Grace DeBord. She has stepped up and been doing a lot, and with her community service hour, and like Mr. Carter said, pretty much every other period. Sorry for other teachers. And she is doing great, and will be a phenomenal educator, and so thank you, Grace DeBord.
All right, I'm going to invite James Cooper up to introduce our next and last piece. This is going to be a combined piece for band and choir. We encourage you to, again, think about that moment when you were younger, like a child, about the glory of the holidays. Here's James Cooper to tell you a bit about our last piece.
Final reminders, please stay in the auditorium. Do not wait in the hallways. Your students will come to find you when they're all. Sorry, my apologies. Sorry. Loosely based on a Czech carol, Catherine K. Davis first wrote and published Carol of the Drum under the pseudonym of C.R.W. Robinson in 1941. This tune was later used and retitled The Little Drummer Boy. We are excited to close the concert with the entire DHS Music Department joining together to play and sing. Happy holidays, and we hope you enjoy Carol of the Drum.
Thank you.
Again, I cannot thank you enough for coming out. Don't these kids just sound great? Give them a hand.